Okay, now before we get started, I'm going to show you a bit of inventory as to what Ness, Paula, and Jeff have in their own inventory so that I don't waste too much time on buying items and stock items. So this is what we have for Ness. This is for Paula. As you can see, we have a ketchup packet from Tucson with the magic truffle. And for Jeff, not many items. Yeah, as you probably might notice, we have a lot of skip sandwiches. Well, you'll see why. But anyway, we are going to go to the bus station, or you could just do some long walking. I don't want to waste too much time going to the bus station. Fine, let's do it so I could show you what it does. You could actually walk to the desert area on foot and you won't have to buy anything for it. I actually did it in my practice run and it's actually way better. But of course it's YouTube, so I have no choice but to show you what happens. Well, you can, but anyway, let's talk to this guy on this side of the road. So we're going to Forside and we have to pay this guy $6. Yeah, sure. And of course we're gonna have this awesome music. I really don't know why I love the music. Maybe it's because it's very catchy, but yeah, it's kind of, maybe it's one of the reasons why I like going on the bus in the game is to listen to the music. Yeah, I still have the soundtrack on my phone and it is still, you know, pretty good to this day. Yeah, this guy would actually give you some text on what would happen because there's going to be something bad happening in, I think it was Dusty Dune Desert. It's kind of similar to the name in Super Mario Galaxy. Okay, it's bumper to bumper. My job is to drive, so I can't get off the bus. So all we have to do is walk around the desert. Okay, let's see what you have to say. It's taking forever. Yes, you do. And we want to stay on this road because you might notice that the characters were sweating once we're off the road. Yeah, so basically people are complaining about, well, the traffic jam. That happens to a lot of people in real life. And check out this red truck here. That was actually changed to a person like that. It was originally gonna have that swell like a Coca-Cola one. But unfortunately, they have to change it because of copyright! Okay, let's see what you have to say. Yeah, the traffic jam is a pain. Oh, sorry about that. I actually put a map on a monitor so I could actually look at where, the items are because it's a little bit hard to, No, I don't want to phone someone. Hang on. Luckily, there's an ATM machine here so I can get as much money out as I can so that I can either buy some upgrades, some food, as well as some healing items. So let's take everything out. So now that we got all the money out, we're going to buy a few things, a Mr. Baseball bat and some other upgrades for Paula as well. Yeah, my practice run is a little bit different on the first file because, well, some of the items are a little bit different, but the gameplay is still the same. Let's get a deluxe frying pan. I don't know what the term deluxe means. Maybe it's even better, or maybe it has more efficient cooking or something like that. So let's sell the thick frying pan. And of course, a lot of people would have made those, like, the thick memes. Like, you know, people would say, you know, thick in like TikTok as such. I don't know. People these days are, I don't know, it's a little bit weird in this modern era where we would focus a lot on, you know, things like cell phones or people acting normal, but now in 2022, the generation is a little bit different now, which is a little strange or something like that. I don't know. But anyway, now that we got all the items we need for upgrades, let's buy a few things. All right, hey there, Granny. Let's see what you have here. So we're gonna have a few refreshing herbs. This is gonna be useful. We can actually get the calorie stick. I might actually. Okay, so we need a couple of wet towels, I don't know, it's a bit funny because when I first played this game, I actually thought someone would piss on them. I don't piss on mine, but I don't know. I always think of that as a kid as wet towels where someone pisses on towels, but it's actually just towels drenched in water. I don't know. It's just a little bit of a coincidence, but so, I just had to stop. I can't stop laughing because I couldn't imagine. Oh man, this is so weird. Anyway, we're going to get a couple refreshing herbs. So we got just enough. Okay, so we're gonna need about a few wet towels just in case. Let's get a calorie stick because we might need to stock up on some food. And after I've done all this, I'm actually gonna move the magic truffle back in Paula's inventory. It's a little strange, even though it's already in the inventory. The basic premise is I want to put the magic truffle in front of the inventory because when you use it in battle, the ketchup packet would use on the magic truffle, and it's a bit of a glitch. Oh, speaking of a glitch, there's actually a special enemy which I'll show you later, and yeah, it's gonna be really awesome if I show you the glitch trick. I haven't actually looked on the internet for it, but it's something really special. Oh, we want to have some space. Now let's talk to this guy. We're gonna have a little bit of a rest. Okay, sorry about that. I just have to double check my, oh no, I do not want to withdraw. I want to deposit. Yeah, I have to double check the map as well as the microphone to make sure it's not losing its progress, because I'm really worried that I might only keep gameplay footage, but whoopsie-daisy, but without the commentary, because that would definitely suck. Because I really don't know how much capacity my microphone would use on a laptop, on a monitor. Yeah, I'm using a laptop for recording, and I'm using a monitor for things as for looking at notes. Anyway, we have this military guy. Let's see what he has. He has a zip gun, a bomb, a bottle rocket, and a Ross promoter. Nope. And hey, we have a monkey. Hello there. So we have to go under the hole and really quickly because we have a smiling spirit coming to get us. Go under. Yeah, we're going under. Oh, great. We have a... How did a mushroom get there? Ah, screw this. I'm not going to fight him. I'm not going to waste my time. Anyway, let's get... Sorry, I thought I was stuck for a moment. Now, anyway, I think we are going to go... Sorry, I was looking at the monitor for a second. We're going to talk to this guy right here. I'm not just a pile of bleached bones. I can't talk. Oh, that's kind of sad. And of course, I looked at the monitor again, so I don't forget where the items are. Yeah, most of the items are actually around the edges of Dusty Dune Desert. Am I saying it right? I don't know. Anyway, we have a crested buka. I don't really know. Maybe it's like an ancient dinosaur or something. I don't know. Anyway, we're going to use some basic attacks, and we're going to also do some freezing. Anyway, we're going to do some basic attacks. You can do hypnosis, I think, and we're going to do some freezing, because a lot of enemies in the desert are immune to... they're actually effective against freezing. It's kind of cool, actually. Yay, we did it! So now we get 1,000 XP each. I don't want to use the sandwich yet. Oh, okay, so we have our first item. This is the double burger. I love double burgers. And hey, the enemies are not on the screen. That's exciting. There's actually a few secrets here. This one is a tiny black sesame. So now there's actually a white sesame that... yeah. I'm not gonna do some... No! Thank you, photographer guy, for wasting our time. Anyway, we have a new enemy, a cute ill UFO. And he has a bow on it. That's so cute. Well, no. We're going to do some basic bashing. We're going to do some freezing attack on this guy. And we're going to shoot this guy. As well, I think. Oh, he's going to do life up? Okay. What was I going to say? The UFO, it will actually drop things at random. I think there are 6 different food items it will drop, but I can't really say them because I forgot most of them, but here is actually some editing text as to what it drops at random. Yay, he's gone. Okay, so he drops a pizza. Yay, he drops a pizza. Okay, sorry, I was looking at my laptop to see if it's not glitching. Yeah, because I always have a problem with my laptop and recording system where... Oh no, we have this guy. We have a buffalo and a desert wolf. So we have a bad buffalo. Jeff, is that Sonstra? Yeah, things couldn't get any worse. We are going to do some bashing at the desert dog. And we're going to do some freezing at this buffalo. Also, paralysis, freezing, and fire does work. Hold on, let me go back. We're going to do paralysis on this guy. Polo, you're going to do some freezing at the desert wolf, which is way more dangerous because the desert wolf would actually use poisonous fangs at you, which basically means you'll get infected with the poison attack, which you want to be careful with. And then for Jeff, you are... gonna use a bomb so he can be useful for once. Freeze beta, and the wolf is gone. Please let it work. Yay, he's okay. So he lost 4 damage. Okay, now that he's stunned, we're going to do some basic attacking on it. So basically he won't actually attack us. That is a relief. I could have used a sorry, I was gonna say a wet towel. Sorry, I just can't really understand weird names like this. I always thought imagining, like, you know, people piss on towels. Yeah, I'm gonna use just a towel. That's basic. Oh, sorry, I just can't really help myself. Hang on, I'm going to use a towel on Jeff. I think there's actually an oasis here. There it is. And we also have a monkey. This one's a Skip Sandwich DX. Yeah, it'd be funny to say DS. Oh, this guy actually speaks English now. So desert, not desert, not dessert. Yeah, it's a basic typo thing, but who cares? We're going to use the Skip Sandwich since it is actually a lot better than the regular Skip Sandwich. Oh, so Paula doesn't have anything. Oh, there's a butterfly here. Let's use it! So we can recover at least some physical power. Okay, there's actually 2 things over here. There it is. There is the something shiny. A contact lenses. So this item is going to be mini useful. I'll say why it's mini useful, which is a different term. There's a double burger. Now, you want to keep at least 1 food item. Because there is actually a sign there that would say something about a pair of contact lenses here. And it will give you a reward. And his name is Penta Giovanni. So he's actually at Foreside Bakery on the 2nd floor. You want to keep that in mind. Now, this is originally where the contact lenses are. Okay, so going on around the edge, as you do. The next present is a PSI caramel, but he's got too many things. God damn it. Hold on. I might need to use up something. I'm not going to use up Paula's inventory because... there's a calorie stick here. I'll be right back. Okay, so I've basically eaten the skip sandwich from Jeff's inventory and gave it to Ness. And we've actually got the PSI caramel. Now, we're going to use it on Ness. Now, the PSI caramel, you don't want to use it on Paula because she's already got the ketchup packet. If you use it on Paula's inventory with the ketchup packet, it will not taste nice and you'll take about at least 10 physical power, I think. I don't know. Maybe a wrong combination would have you half of the health you're giving. It's not accurate, but at least it's zero. How is it zero? You want to watch out for that spear guy. This one is a Sun and Guts pill. Watch out! Run! 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 Ah, whatever, we'll just face it. Now, this guy is a jerk. This one is the Smiling Sphere. This is actually one of the enemies that will have a 1 in 128 item drop. It will drop a Meteor Atom or something like that. Now, listen to the music! I actually really love this music. It has like a robotic kind of feel with its own techno beam. Not beam, sorry. I just love the music in it. It feels very futuristic and it feels very, very cool. Now, to get rid of this guy, he's effective against hypnosis, I think. Don't use freeze on it. I did do it once and it has a zero chance of freezing effect on him. So fire does work. But here, we're going to use... We don't have a PSI shield, gamma? I think it's gamma. Which basically means it will make us immune to PSI attacks to everyone in the crowd. I'm gonna use it on Paula just in case. And for Jeff, you are going to use nothing. Yep, use nothing. You can just do some basic shooting. Or you can use a steel thing, but we can't do that because it's a 1 in 128 chance of an item. Oh, he fell asleep. Okay, now it's open fire. Uh-oh. Come on. Okay, once it explodes, you want to mash the L button. Or even mash the default button. 700, that is not much. Okay, so I need to figure out, oh, okay, we made it. Now, in this hole there, right next to that person, it's actually a dead end. Uh-oh, someone's got sunstroke. It is Paula. So we're going to use hold on, do we have any wet towels? Oh, I just can't stop laughing. Oh, sorry. I just couldn't really imagine the meaning of wet towel. Anyway, let's use it on Paula. There we go. She's actually cured from sunstroke, but not for a while. Oh, something really cool. There are two things I've noticed. I've actually did like a resting thing. So basically Jeff was on sunstroke and we've actually rested while someone is at sunstroke. And guess what happens? Jeff's health has been fully recovered, but he still has the sunstroke health problem. It's actually pretty cool, because I thought he would, like, die for an instant, but apparently the game is actually pretty nice enough. So, basically, you want to talk to this guy, and you want to give him a particular food item. Basically, anything that's food-related. I actually gave him I think it was a fresh egg. He was actually fine with it, but we're going to give him something weak. I'd say just a skip sandwich, because let's give it out of Paula's inventory. Oh, wait, what? Hey, wait a second. Oh, okay, so next up, we're going to have a bit of a rest. Now, the best part is you don't have to pay. This guy would be nice enough to let you stay in this house for free. And we did not fix a single thing. Okay, let's see what he needs to fix. Oh, wait, nothing? Oh, right, we don't have any broken items. And apparently he doesn't. Now, before I finish this off, I'm going to do a little bit of a discussion about, well, some of the Power Rangers things. I've actually made a video about Power Rangers Super Samurai as an episode review, and surprisingly, it actually hit almost 120 views in like 5 days. I was really shocked about this because I thought it would be less than average because of it being bland. But apparently, I only did commentary on it, and it's actually somewhat enjoyable. Yeah, Super Samurai is not a good season, especially with the poor acting and the storytelling that doesn't make any sense. And of course, there's actually one season I particularly hate the most. Do you know what it is? Wild Force. I hated Wild Force. I was 14 years old at the time watching it, and it's an animal-based season, and it's pretty bad. Like, it's kind of hard to explain it, but there's a lot of issues. Like, basically, the storytelling feels like a children's story. The acting, completely painful. The team-ups are only good. The Time Force cast and even Forever Red. Okay, so now we have to see the Black Sesame Seed. But anyway, the two other things. The villains are actually okay, because I was so angry with the season. And the characters are the worst Rangers I've ever seen. But like I said, it's actually my opinion on Wild Force. You're actually fine to disagree with it, but oh man, I hate that season. The characters are so unlikable. The mentor is nothing but a pain, honestly. She's actually lined up with G and Samurai. Anyway, we have new enemies. These are, what are they called? Oh, the Skeleton. Similar to a Scorpion, these guys are really dangerous, both in this game and in real life. So what we're going to do is, we're going to do some basic bashing, and they are effective against freezing, which is actually good. And we're going to do some shooting. Now, these guys would have, of course, the poisonous stinger. Yeah, so you want to be careful with it. Now, don't worry, if you get stung like that, you can actually use either a refreshing herb or healing beta. Yeah, healing beta would also work. So we're going to use a refreshing herb on Paula. Okay, that's good. Now you want to go to the top. Oh my god, there's a shit ton of enemies. I might have to use one of the skip sandwiches as well. So we're going to do some bashing. We're going to freeze an enemy on this guy. And Jeff, you do some shooting. Oh, not again. There's actually a special glitch I found out with the smiling sphere. What happened was, I basically won the battle after all three of the characters are dead. Yeah, so basically all the characters died before I actually won the battle. Okay, good. We have at least one skip sandwich that we can use. Let's use it on Paula and let's quickly get PSI healing. Oh, no. Let's use up one of the refreshing herbs so we can at least make some space. So we're gonna give it to Jeff. Now let's go up. Up, 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 up. Oh no. Oh. Okay. Cause I wanna find the sesame seed. Oh well, that guy has a pretty cool background. Yeah, we do some freezing and some bashing. That's what you do to most enemies in the Dusty Dune Desert. I still don't know if I'm actually pronouncing the town right. But there's actually a bit of a text on what happens if you talk to the white sesame seed and the black one, or whatever it is. Oh, now we finally got Shield Omega? Is that the right one? Oh, okay. I thought it was a back attack. Okay, so we're getting close to... Are you serious? Both of them? Yeah, this is the glitch on what happens if all the characters die and you win at the same time. there will be some glitch things that will happen. I did not even found it once on the internet. And it took me about... I did saw it first, and then I had to do... Then I had to, like, go and rewind so I can capture the footage and wait for about 10 minutes before I get the right one. What? Ness is homesick? Uh-oh. Okay. That was a relief. There is the sesame seed. Yep, and apparently the sesame seed is crying. Apparently he doesn't have a face. Ooh, come back here. Or not. Okay, so now that we finally got the butterfly, I need to look for another set of skeleton bones. And I think I might know where it is. I have seen the first one, which is at the start of the video, I think. And we also have some enemies that we need to get rid of. It's good for experience points, but it's not really fun if you just keep repeating it over and over again, because there are high points where you can actually die because of either poison attacks or strong enemies. Uh-oh, let's get away from this buffalo. The buffalo is the worst enemy. He doesn't want it to be talked. That's really upsetting. Oh, and here is actually the bottle rocket. Hold on. Did someone get sunstroke? Paula again? Don't worry, we're gonna use a healing alpha on Paula. I actually forgot. Anyway, you could actually walk through this direction instead of going around the edge, which is actually safer and it's less time consuming, but I want to show you all the mini secrets. Well, maybe, because I have actually seen a couple of secrets on this before, especially that one enemy that looks like a caterpillar. I'll show an image of what it looks like. Yeah, it's actually a rare enemy that will appear, like, on screen occasionally if you go back and forth. I've defeated it once and it gives you a lot of experience points, like, a lot. But from my experience, you don't want to upgrade too fast too much. So now we've got $10,000 and Ness has got Sunstrike. We're not going to heal him yet because we're going to have a mini game here. This is. So I'm Big Brother Puncho. Yeah, these guys are basically they're basically a slot machine, which is weird, but here it is. I'm a broken slot machine, but the Sanchez brothers and their friend are a very cheerful trio. They will make you happy. Would you like to insert a buck? Yeah, sure. It's basically a basic gambling game. And these guys would actually spin around based on an angle. And I failed. Oh, whoops. Now, this actually appears at random. They can actually give you a random item if you actually win a type of lottery. I've actually done this once, and when I actually did a few old practice runs, I never really cared for it because I don't like gambling because I'm not really good at it. Like this, for example. Yeah, there's actually four different items here, and here's a list of what these guys will drop as items. Oh, come on! Yeah, I've only got one item, and I think it was a skip sandwich, and it took me like about 20 attempts just to get it. So basically, I've used up $20 just to get a skip sandwich, which is okay. It's a little cheaper than getting the skip sandwiches as normal, but... Oh, are you serious? Yeah, because if you at least win the lottery, one of the guys will actually go up to you and give you a... You know what? I'm just going to spend $20 on just gambling. So I'll be right back. Okay, come on. Yes! Yes! I actually got something. a big jackpot. Here's a big prize for you, amigo. Ness and his friends won a chick as a prize. Are you that's it? That's it? A chick? It's got... This machine is a scam. I've wasted $17 just for a chick. Well, a chick as a baby chicken, to be precise. I just can't believe I wasted $17 on just that one item. I would rather spend $17 on a rare Wii game. But don't worry, guys. Once you have a chick in your inventory, it will actually evolve into a chicken, and it will actually sell for a bunch of money. But it's just like Pokemon, but I'm not much of a Pokemon fan. At least it's, well, something. Anyway, hold on, I actually forgot what I was supposed to do. I'm supposed to use Healing Beta on everybody, and I'm gonna have to wait until that the baby chicken at least hatches so that I can at least sell it to the market and actually have a ton of money out of it. Or maybe sell it to a farm, but oh no. We have some more enemies here. So we're gonna talk to this guy, and I think we're going to end things off here. So next time on Earthbound, we are going to Forside and finish everything in the desert. Should I call Excargo Express? Nah, I don't think so. See you guys there, after I gotten cure from homesickness. Thank you.